D-poison. Which I'll probably use. You get poison a lot. Ah! How dare you not do any damage. I messed up my complete strategy here. Inigo needs better armor. Two small heals. .98, close enough. Only 7 points away from his total. It is good. Alright, we go around the corner. Skeletoni. I mean statue. You know. Sentinel. This thing's pretty friggin' tough. Inigo will just attack. Milo will not attack. He will. I don't think D-Soul will work on this. We might have to use Revive. Alright, so we're gonna try to slow this thing then? We're gonna quicken ourselves. Let's quicken ourselves. And Pyra will boost Inigo. So he'll do more damage. Attack factor increases by 113 points, and then we got speed factor and defense increasing for everybody. He's still gonna really 37. Yeah, he's got two attacks at least. Yeah. I think the only other thing I can cast on him, not Sentry. I call it Sentry. It's Sentinel. Maybe a high level blast spell. Or burst. I'm not gonna try. D-Soul, I don't think that's gonna do much. Oh, you know what? I forget. I think we want this one. I'm not completely sure, but I think the second level burst is good for multiple enemies, so it's going to spread the damage around, but there's nothing to spread, so he'll just get one lower burst. So I think with blast, we increase that. I don't know, let's see. If not, I'll just have him hit the thing next round. So with her, I will try to slow this thing, and in this case, I will use the lower level slow for one character, same reason. Speed decreases again. 29, that's pretty good. Oh, and there you go. Burst really works. So here, we get a great axe. And that's not what I wanted to do. Is it better than what he has? Let's see. Oh, wait. We have to give it. It's gonna be better because it's a great axe versus a battle axe. At least I think so. But we're gonna have to. What am I doing? Good God. Give the great axe to Milo. Come on. Keep pressing it. Thank you. Weapon factor, yeah, up from 112 to 134. This will help. Because I want to craft him a weapon, is what I think I want to do. Great axe. Weapon, I think the battle hammer may or may not be better, but I think his next weapon is going to be crafted with mithril. So, that was worth it. And he wasn't that tough, you just had to watch out and buff yourself. And heal yourself once the battle's over. How are these guys doing? Small heal for our cleric. I like this theme, it's a good change of pace. Berserkers. Let's go berserk on the berserkers! See how he gets a lot less points than Inigo taken off? Feel that, that's for sure. Maybe that's what I should do next. Save up 18,000. Make another one of these. Mithril armor. Well, lucky Pyrite hasn't even got hit. Nobody's even been targeting her lately. Yeah. I don't know what's with me lately. Keep. Tool force, we know we use all the points available. There's 1 point less. If you follow me. Okay. Now we leave this area and go deeper into the dungeon. There to the right is that dead end. We go this way. Yes, I think it's this way. Yes. There's not a whole hell of a lot in the immediate area. We could fight more sentries. They come back, you know, once you go back in the dungeon. There's nothing else of note there. That is one big battle, right? Yeah. 14 we have already. Yeah, we could do that. We could make him another one. Mithril armor for our friend. There's not a whole hell of a lot around, unless there's stuff that the map maker missed again, which is possible. Running into trouble, the some reason that means we have the initiative and can attack a round and then attack a whole other round. Basically, we get a round of free attacks and then this is like a normal round. One point. Inigo, yay! What's his total now? 212. These usually mean tougher monsters ahead. After we're through the, you know, the braziers or the torches, whatever you want to call them. How dare you duck behind your shield? Come out and fight like a skeleton. Okay, 30 points right there. Finish him off, Pyra. That's a good Pyra. Very good Pyra. I think I pressed it. Okay. Alright, there's a little niche up ahead. I just want to see if there's anything in it. What are these? Demi whites? Yeesh. Doesn't sound good. Nice, Mantoro down. Wonder if I should take out the demi whites. What do they do? They look dangerous. Sure we'll run into them again, they'll use some kind of devastating power on us. Okay, it's a little niche here. Oh, okay, it's a regular fountain. So then here... there's a sentinel around the corner. Do we want to fight that thing? I want to see if there's anything with it. Alright, you know, I'm going to pass on it. Down to the left, supposedly nothing, but maybe a chest. Nice, one out. Two down. Three down. Three. And you fall down. Apparently nothing here. Okay. More berserkers. Ouchies, man. Ah, damn. All those things. I'm beating the crap out of Inigo. Yay. Milo levels up to 25. Catching up. At least to one of us. Screen is increased to level 2. Oh, screen silences spellcasters. Maybe I should start using that. Small heal on Milo. And then we will continue. No. Gosh. Okay. The spinner to the left. We'll get back to that. Supposedly there's nothing down here but a sentinel? Apparently so. So we're gonna take the spinner. I mean, so it's probably good to grind on those things. I would like to go that way eventually. But I want to see what's at the other end of this side. Supposedly a dead end, but let's just make sure. Alright, now we'll go. Alright, good. Supposedly nothing here. Billows? The billows look like nasty pillows. Oh, oof. I had a feeling these Reapers are bad news. Now, if he casts D-Soul on your cleric, you gotta go home or restore a game. Because he's the only one who can cast this spell. Revive. Comes back with like half his hit points or something. Or less. Actually, that's. Yeah, that's less. Like a third? Get this thing out. Good. Was pretty brutal. Nothing here. So there's something interesting. There's some kind of event that happens up here. Don't really know what it is, but we'll find out. Okay. How dare you catch us by surprise? Unhand me, sir. You look so glamorous, the Maligator things. Look, they have eyeshadow and, like, mohawks. Like, made out of pink and purple. Well, Pyra needs some healing. Demi whites. Big group. Man, I want to see what cool thing happens. How much money do I have? Nice, definitely have enough now. Ah! So what I want to do. Okay, that transports us quite a ways east. Now you could also, in the spinner, instead of going to the left when you approach the spinner from the south, so instead of going west, left, you could just go forward, which is north, and go around manually. Of course, there is something there. There's a reason to go that way, actually. But we can go back. Yeah, we can go back. Because there's a magic hood, which I want to give to Milo, and there's an angel feather, which, why not? Because we'll be right there. So this is the second half of the dungeon. I think I'll go back and get those things, and then I'll warp back to town. I could stop by to get some other things as well. But by that point... Yeah, let's go around. See if we can get a few more things at least. These things are gonna start wearing us down, because we're starting to run a little low on mana, so... Once we're out of mana, we just got the goal. Oh jeez, really? Level 2 burst. Sheesh. I knew they did something. Some special thing. They look special. smaller heals. Starting to lose my mind here. Oh. Saving, continuing. What are these billow things? They look like brains with eyes. The rest of us okay? Yeah. Yeah, I knew we couldn't make it too much further. Yeah, we want to go that way, and then we'll go the manual way. I'll show you the manual way back east and west. I mean, if you take the way we took, there's no encounters. It's like a shortcut. It's nice, too, to see something different, you know, actually outside for a little bit. Yeah, we're gonna need some good time healing after this. Some good time healing. Yeehaw! Nice, Milo. Oh, good. All right, so we want to take this way. It's gonna be quite a long track back, though. Running into trouble. What we're good at. We won't be coming this way again, we'll just use the little cinematic way through. Okay, so, yep. Mana draining stuff. Yay! Because we love that. Really don't need any healing, so. But there's two items this way. One of them's worth it, the other one not really by itself, but we'll be over this way. There's one on each side. Well, picking on Milo Day, huh? Oh, he didn't kill that one. Nice. We really focused on that one that was on the left. One down. You're doomed. Yeah. Oh, jeez, let me get to the chest already. Oof. Damn. Die, damn you. Thank you. Yeesh. Magic hood. Who has it? Indigo has it. Can you give it to Milo? No, Milo's full. Milo has to give something to Pyra. How about an extra great axe? I wish I could go and give more stuff without having to go through all this again. Yay, you can finally wear something better than the fur hood. It's going up 6 points. Up to 155 is an armor factor. Now, Inigo's at 121. 155. Pyro's at 148, so we have to increase Inigo's armor soon. He's taking a beating. If anything happens, let's pull out that. Okay. And there's another item on the other side. That probably isn't worth it, but hey, we could use the experience from these things, I guess. I guess. If I have to. Damn you. Nice. guess. Ouch. He's close, he's like 160 or something? 170? Close enough. Angel Feather! Wouldn't go here just for that, but we... It's right nearby. Came here for the hood, really, so... I mean, if we want to, we can see if we can withstand... some more, mana draining stuff. I don't know if we're gonna make it. And then we'll warp back. There's a bunch of things over there. You know what? I think we're gonna warp back right now. So we can carry those other things. Because we have one or two things to sell, right? So.